Hey friends!
Hey friends!
Hey friends! It's me, Alana. Welcome back to my channel. You are all sunflowers in a world full of weeds. Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. It is me, Alana. For this video, I wanted to do a end of winter haul for you all. So I accumulated a couple of books. So the first couple books I got were a manga. So I got the first three volumes of Kyukyu Sweeper. So this is an author that I've read before and I really enjoyed their work. So I decided to check this one out. I believe it's about this organization called Sweepers who like make sure that people are not taken over by demons who latch onto like their darkness, and they help clean like the spaces of those people so that way they can have a clean mind and get rid of the demons basically. So it seems like a really fun and cool story, and since it's only three volumes, I thought it would be a good buy and steal. Next I got Queen's Quality, which is basically a spin-off series for the Kyukyu Sweeper, and again I got it for the same reason, because the artwork looked really cool and it seemed like a really cool story. Next I got Spy Family by Tatsuya Endo. So this is actually a really cute story. It's about a guy who is a spy for his home country, and they give him his next mission, which is to acquire a family and basically integrate his child into this school to get close to this like government official that they need information from. So he acquires this girl who's a telepath, and his wife ends up being an assassin, and they all don't really know each other that well, except for the girl with the telepathy, because she can read their minds and she knows each of their jobs is like a spy and an assassin. I've already read this one. It's really cute and fun, so I'm actually really excited that I bought this. Next, I have volume one of Arisa by Natsumi Ando. So this I actually read a couple years ago, but I wanted to give it a try because I lost track and just like never finished, and I got this for like $3 on Right Stuff Anime. And then the last two volumes of manga that I got were volume 5 and 7 of Animal Academy. So I have, I think, 1 through 4, and I wanted to complete my set, so I got both of these because they were on sale on Right Stuff as well, and I figured it would be a good time as any to go ahead and grab it while I could. Alright, the next book I got was Muted by Tammy Charles, and it's actually a novel in verse. It's about a girl who wants to be in the music industry, and so she meets this man who basically invites her into this world, and soon she realizes she's trapped because she has gotten in too deep. And so it's about her journey with that. I'm definitely looking forward to this. I haven't read too many books in verse, so I'm definitely trying to broaden my horizons and get more into it, so I'm definitely looking forward to checking this out. Alright, the next book I grabbed was a book that I bought on my own, and it is a book I've been wanting for a while, and it's Bound to You by Alyssa Brandon. I believe this was like a werewolf story. It sounded really interesting when I looked at it on Amazon, so I'm excited to check this out. Hopefully it lives up to my expectations. If not, that'll be very sad. Next, I got Wild Hunger, which is an Heirs of Chicagoland novel by Chloe Neal. So this is actually a spin-off from the original Chicagoland vampire series. I believe it's about someone's daughter, but I can't remember whose daughter it is. So when I bought this, I decided that I wanted to actually go back and reread the series so that way I could be caught up and remember things. So I got this, and then I went back and got the other two, which you'll probably see later. But I'm definitely excited to check this out because I like vampires and supernatural worlds and fantasies, so definitely excited to dive back into this world. Next, I bought Ace of Shades by Amanda Foody. Kay from I Love Books OK recommended this to me, and Amanda Foody has another book that's coming out this year that actually caught my interest, so I figured I would buy this one and see if I liked her writing style and her storytelling, just to see if I would like this other book that's coming out. And I'm definitely excited to check this out because it gives me definite like The Beautiful vibes almost, but just not as vampire-y, more trickstery, if that makes sense. So I'm actually looking forward to this. Next, so Books A Million was having a sale and it was a buy two get the third free for all of the PC Cast and Kristen Cast books. So I bought the next three books in the House of Night series. I have the first two, so I bought the next three after that because my goal is to actually reread this series and finish it just to see what I missed and see what all the hype was about. So I'm definitely looking forward to doing that. I think I might actually make it even a vlog series. Let me know if you'd be interested in that. All right, so the next book I grabbed was the Barnes & Noble exclusive, like, black edition of How the King of Elfheim Learned to Hate Stories. This was actually the last edition in my store, so I just went ahead and bought it because I wanted it to match my box set of the trilogy, and I'm just weird like that. So I'm super glad that I was able to get my hands on this. All right, next I was sent Wings of Ebony by JL by Simontine. They sent me a signed first edition. So thank you to them for sending me this. I literally flipped my ish when I opened the box and saw this because it's so pretty and I just love it so much. And that signature just brings me joy. Next, I got The House in the Cerulean Sea by TJ Klune. So he actually lives close to my Barnes & Noble and he came in one day and signed our paperback stock. So I took that as a sign that it was probably time for me to go ahead and buy the book. So it is signed, which I am so excited about here. And I am actually looking forward to checking this book out because I've heard such good things about this in his writing. Next, I was sent A Taste for Love by Jennifer Yen. This was sent to me by Penguin Tweens, so thank you to them for sending me this. I'm definitely excited. I'm looking forward to all of the Asian-inspired stories that are coming out by Asian authors. I believe this is about a girl who loves, like, baking, and so her mom sets her up to take part in this baking competition. But what her mom doesn't tell her is that she's also setting her up on a basically like a bachelor-esque type thing too within the baking competition, if that makes sense. So I don't know, it just sounded really cool and super cute. So I'm definitely looking forward to this. Next up, here are the first two novels in the Chicagoland Vampire series that I told you about that I got. I think Some Girls Bite is the first one and then Friday Night Bites is the second one, I believe. And yeah, I read the first one already and I just had so much fun rereading it, so I'm definitely looking forward to picking up the second one and rereading that as well. The next book I managed to grab was one that like caught my eye because of the cover and then the story just sounded really interesting, and that is The Midnight Bargain by C.L. Polk. Like, this looks so beautiful. So this is about a girl who practices magic in secret. She lives in a society where everybody has magic and the women are allowed to study it until they get married, and then at that point their magic is supposed to take the back seat to their husband and children, and they're supposed to just provide for their family. So it's about a girl who is studying magic in secret and she never wants to get married because she never wants to have to put that on the back burner. She wants to have the same opportunities that men do. And I guess at some point she somehow makes a bargain with somebody, and I don't know, but this cover was so gorgeous and the story still sounded interesting. It is an adult fantasy, so I feel like it's a nice one to try, maybe? I don't know, I haven't heard anybody talk about this, but this is what happens when you get sucked in by a cover. And the last book I have in this haul is Gideon the Ninth by Tamsin Muir. This was sent to me by one of my subscribers, Jordan E. McNeil. So thank you so much, Jordan, for sending this to me. I've been wanting to read this for a minute, so I'm excited to finally get in and see what everybody has been raving about. I'm so excited for this. If you like the video, please like it down below. If you have any comments, questions, concerns, please leave all that in the comment section. If you're not good at commenting, I'm gonna go ahead and say leave me an emoji down below. And if you want to see more videos from me, please hit that subscribe button. You are all sunflowers in a world full of weeds.